Hello children, hello second class children, how are you all? How are you doing? I hope you are doing so good and great. And I also hope that you all in your houses only. Yes, don't go outside for playing or any play area, okay? Take some distance. We maintain some distance and also take precautions. Sanitize your hands and wear mask when you are going out, wherever you are. Okay, please take precautions and please listen to the words of your parents. Don't neglect. Don't be so negligent and don't neglect them. Okay, please listen to the words of your parents. Very good, Nana, very good. And as usual, I like to start your class with a very beautiful poem today. Not poem, it's a rhyme. This rhyme is from Dev and Eva channel. Have you seen this Dev and Eva channel? And the rhymes are, they were pretty cool and they were very soothing to listen. Yes, I like those rhymes and I like to sing a rhyme from that lesson. Are you ready with me? Are you ready? Yes. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let it go again. Why did you let it go? Because it bit my finger so. Which finger did it bite? This little finger on my right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let it go again. Why did you let it go? Because it bit my finger so. Which finger did it bite? This little finger on my right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let it go again. Why did you let it go? Because it bit my finger so. Which finger did it bite? This little finger on my right. Yes, this is a very beautiful and enjoyable poem today. Rhyme, it's a rhyme. Do you like this rhyme? Yes, you practice this rhyme in your home. Okay, very good children, very good. What's our previous video about? That video is about the left pronouns, they and it. I have told you about they, it, and also describing words. So I have given more questions from which you have heard. Yes, from this pronouns, and I have given some questions from this describing words. And I have also given some questions from your magic porridge, magic first lessons grammar and second lesson. See, we have completed yesterday second lessons. Only this rhyming words were left. So today what you are going to learn means, all of you open your Mulberry course book. All of you open your Mulberry course book and also open your grammar tree book. I have already posted you what and all you have to prepare, and I also given some exercise you to do. Okay, so please practice them so that you came to know what is about pronoun and what is about describing words. Okay, I have given some examples on your on the board also, and I told you to note them in your classwork notes. So after coming to the schools from 16th August, I will check your classwork notes and homework notes and your grammar tree book. So be thorough and please go through all the classes and write your classwork notes with a very good handwriting and also grammar tree book. Okay? Very good, children. I hope I you have to do this work. Must. Okay. I'm going to see. I'm going to check all your notes from 16th August. Yes. I think you all will enjoy coming again to the schools. We are back to schools now. Yes. Yes. Very good. And open page number 14, ma. Open page number 14. Here we are telling about. We are going to say about a few prepositions. You can't understand the word prepositions, but place words tells us where the person, place, and animal or thing is. First one is on. First one is on. On means meeda. Meeda. On means Meeda in Telugu. Okay, I already told you I only use a little bit Telugu, but I will explain all the grammar and all the lessons in English only. If it might be tough for you for few classes only, you came to habituate to understand in English. Okay, I don't want to use much more Telugu. Okay, ma? Yes. On means meeda. See where the cat sat on. Where the cat sat. The cat. Write. Open your classwork notes and write. Okay. The cat sat on the chair. Where the cat sat. The cat sat on the chair. The cat sat on the chair. This cat, where did he sat? On the chair. If we rub this on, there is no meaning to this sentence. If we rub this on, there is no meaning. The cat sat the chair. No meaning. So, to change a sentence in a meaningful way, we have to add prepositions. That means in, on, under, inside, outside, like this. So we have to add on. Why on? Why on? Why we have to use on means because on means meeda. It might also sit under, but according to this picture the cat sat on the chair. Pilli chair meeda kuchundi. Okay? Not chair kinda or not chair paina. Chair meeda. Okay? So that's the importance of on. And little girl, one more example. Little girl sat on her mother's lap. What is meant by mother's lap? Mother's lap means amma ollo kuchodamu. Yes, you all children, as a children, you like to sat in your mother's lap. Yes or no? Yes, you all love your mother. You all love your mummy. Yes? Very good. You all love your ma. So, a little girl, where does she sat? She sat on her mother's lap. Lap means odi, odi in Telugu. Ollo kuchodam in Telugu, okay? For your understanding purpose, I am saying in Telugu. Lap, do remember this word. Mother's lap, father's lap, grandmother's lap, like this, odi, that says ollo kuchodamu. Okay, yes, so this is how we can use if we sit or something is we kept this duster on the table. One more example. I kept duster on my table. Where I kept the duster? I kept the duster on my table, not in the table. In the table means lopala, not in, on. I kept the duster. Nenu duster table meeda pettano. Here on means meeda. Okay. Yes, very good. Note down this examples. Note down these examples, and also I will give some more examples, and we do exercises from grammar tree book also. Okay. Yes, we have to learn four prepositions today. Yes, on is over, and next under. What is meant by under? Under means krinda or kinda. Yeah, see, by seeing the picture you can say it very easily, that where did the cat sit here? The cat sat on the table, and the cat hide under the chair. The cat hide. What is meant by hide? Do you like the play called hide and seek? Do you like a play called hide and seek? Yes. Someone will count the numbers 1 to 10 by closing their eyes, and the other children will hide on some places. So he have to find out them. He have to seek them. That means he have to go through all the round of every corner of a class, and he find the children. Yes, you are out. So these are the place you will all love to play with each other. Yes, yes. So the cat hide under the table. Where the cat hide? Under the table. Why I use under? Under means krinda. If you are playing a game called hide and seek, if you climb a table and you sat on the table, you are visible. Ante while you are playing, while meeru aadukuneetappudu, if you sat on the table meeda kuchunte, the others can see you. Vere vallu mimmalni chudagalaru. If you hide under the table, ade meeru table kinda daakunte, so it was some difficult to find you. So that's the game, kada. So where the cat hide? It hide under the table. Yes, yes. I stood under an umbrella. Do you all like umbrellas, ma? Yes, we all love umbrellas. Why means they protect us from the rain. Yes, we keep umbrella like this. So whenever in a rainy season, we kept our umbrella with us, because it protect us from the rain and rainy drops. If we not kept our umbrella with us, we will caught with a cold and cough, as you know. Okay, we can protect ourselves by standing under the umbrella. Okay, here we have to use under umbrella, not on umbrella. Umbrella meeda undamu manamu, umbrella kinda untamu. So we are using krinda, under. Okay, yes. In this way you can write some more examples. Okay, you can write some more examples. The train, the ship sails under the bridge. Yeah, children, we have seen some examples from on and under. One more example is, the ship sails under the bridge. Where the ship sails? The ship sails under the bridge. See, if you have gone through the bridge in Nellur, we have a bridge that connects to Nellur to Kovur. Yeah, it's a it will connect from Nellur to Kovur. Have you gone through? Vellara eppudaina? Yes. And you can see water, Penna River. We have Penna River in Nellur. Yes. So in Penna River, not this time, a long time ago, there was a full of water, and we can see many boats and ships, they were sailing on the water. Yes, where the boat sailing? The boat was sailing on the water under the bridge. See, note down this. The boat was sailing on the water, under the bridge. It's a very important to note down, because don't confuse between on and under. On means meeda, under means krinda. The boat was sailing on the water under the bridge. The boat was sailing on the water. Assume this as a bridge. This is a bridge. So these are all the water. These are all the water. And here we can see a boat. This is not a boat. This is triangle. Assume this as a boat. Okay. You draw a good diagram of boat. Okay. See here under the bridge we can see the water. And this shape is sailing on the water. Yes. Very good. So I know, I hope that you understood the concept of on and under. On ante meeda. On means meeda. Under means krinda. And next two examples, inside and outside, I will discuss very clearly in the next video class. Okay, now we have completed first lesson grammar and first lesson's poem, that's the little plant. We have completed some part of the grammar part from the little plant. See, open page number 25, we have completed connections and also this. And what is this? This is the order of the poem. First, the seed was sleeping. Yes. The seed was sleeping under the sand, under the earth. Then the rain came, then the sun came to wake up the seed. Yes, the sun came and the seed woke up and it opened its eyes. So after the rain came from the sky, it feels very happy and that seed began to plant. A sapling came from out of the seed. So this is a very little and cute poem. So here are, we placed the order. First one is 2, 1, 4, 5, 3. I hope you all have done this work in your earlier class. So, and ma'am has gone through the meanings, opposite, plural forms and question and answers. So now it's time to know some sort of grammar. Okay, rhyming pairs, rhyming, rhyming pairs, pairs. What is rhyming pairs? Open your page number 27. Rhyming means the word, if there are many words that rhymes in a same manner. That rhymes in a same manner. See, here we have one poem that was written by R.L. Stevenson. The rain is raining all around. It falls on field and tree. It rains on the umbrellas here and on the ships at sea. The rain is coming all around. Yes? The rain is coming all around. It falls on where it falls. It falls on road, it falls on our houses, and also it falls on trees, it falls on field, you know, fields. It rains on the umbrellas here. If we keep under the umbrella, under the umbrella, that umbrella protects us from the rain droplets. Yes? Next, and on the ships at sea. So, we can see rain everywhere. We can see rain on top of our houses, on roads, on buildings, on fields, and also on the rivers and seas also. So here we are going to learn rhyming words. Rhyming. See, second one, match the pictures to the words to make the rhyming pairs. One has been done for you, like loud cloud. See, here they have given a picture of what is this kite. How many of you like kite? Yes, I hope all the children, they like to play with the kite. Where? At the time of Pongal. In the time of Pongal holidays, all the kids, they like to play with the kites. So here, what is a rhyming word? Kite spelling. What is the spelling of kite? K-I-T-E. Here we have to connect the kite to white. Kite, white. And also right. These are rhyming words. Rhyming words means that sounds same. That sounds same. See, I-T-E, kite, ite. Kite, ite. White, ite. Right, ite. In this way, the words that gives a same pronunciation, they were the rhyming pairs. If two or three words are there, if they have the same rhyming, if they have the same rhyming, they were known as rhyming pairs. Okay, next. Here we can see a star also. What is the spelling of a star? S-T-A-R, star. So connect the star with car. Star, car, bar. Like this. Star, car, bar. No need to spell as car. No. No need to spell r. Okay, delete that. And your R should be silent. R should be silent. I love cars very much. I love my red car. I love my red car. You just want to say car, not car. You don't want to spell car. Okay, car, bar, star. So you can match star to car here. Okay, what is the next one? Mouse. Mouse. What is the spelling of mouse? M-O-U-S-E, mouse. So what is a rhyming pair for the mouse? Mouse, house. Mouse, house. See, these are all one. O-U-S-E, M-O-U-S-E, mouse. H-O-U-S-E, house. Mouse, house. So like this, we have rhyming pairs. And also see, we have some other pairs, some other pairs. Let's go through that. Let's go through that. Seema, here we can see a picture of a moon. A picture of a moon, right? What is the spelling of a moon? M-O-O-N, moon. So we have to pair it with the rhyming pair called soon. Soon, moon. Soon, moon. Okay, here you can see here. Soon, moon. Next, what is the picture? It is, this is a picture of cloud. C-L-O-U-D, cloud. You can see clouds above the sky. Yes, you can see the clouds above the sky. These clouds are nothing but the water vapor. Okay, you don't want that depth information. Yes, you will enjoy clouds when you are going through that clouds in an aeroplane. You all love aeroplane, right? The kids, you all love to travel in aeroplane. If you got a chance to travel in aeroplane, while we are crossing the clouds or while we are going through the clouds, it was an eye feast. We'll feel very happy while we are going through the clouds. Yes? Cloud. So what is the rhyming pair for the cloud? So here, first one, they have given loud. L-O-U-D, loud. See, O-U-D, O-U-D is same. And O-O-N, O-O-N is same. So here we have to see the rhyming pairs. Loud, cloud. Okay, and one more. B. 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 B means, in beehive, we can see bees that makes honey. Right? For bee, what is the rhyming word? Bee, tree. Bee, tree. Bee, tree. Bee, tree. Okay. So these are the rhyming pairs. Okay? Yes, I hope you all enjoyed this class, ma. In the next class, we'll go through the second lesson, grammar. Second lesson, grammar part, and all these professions, and choose the right answers and everything. Today, we have learned about in, on, and under prepositions, and also how to spell the words bow, cow, show, like that. The words that gives the same sound, and also some rhyming pairs, and also we have seen first lesson, little plants grammar. Little plants grammar is completed. In the next lesson, we'll go through the merchant's purse. Second lesson, merchant's purse lesson grammar. Okay. Yes, I hope you all understood this class and you are doing good and great. So please write all your classworks and homeworks neatly with a very good handwriting, and make sure that you have to come to schools with your work only. Okay, we are starting our classes from 16th onwards. So I think you all students will feel happy that you can meet your friends. Yes. But we should be very careful. We should be very careful with while we are in a crew, we are in a group. We should be careful. We should take precautions. Okay? So be ready for the objective test. I have given most of the questions from article. Where we have seen this article? First lesson. In the first lesson, we have articles. No? No, wait one second. Countable, uncountable, we have seen countable, uncountable, special name, exact name. That means common noun, proper noun, and also one, many. That means singular, plural, and rhyming words. Yes, for rhyming words. So you can get most of the questions from this. Rhyming words, singular, plural, and some of the questions from describing words also. So you please thorough with the what the lessons you have completed. So take care, children. Have a nice day. Bye. Very good.